Shake the room, Fire Nation. JLD here, and welcome to episode 1775 of EOFire, where I chat with entrepreneurs on fire 7 days a week. Are you ready to master productivity, discipline, and focus in 100 days? Well, then visit themasteryjournal.com. Now let's chat with today's featured guest, Ron White. Ron, are you prepared to ignite?
Yes, I am.
Yes. Ron's a two-time USA memory champ. He held the record for fastest to memorize a deck of cards in the USA. He's been featured on Nat Geo Brain Games and Stan Lee's Superhumans. Ron, take a minute, fill in some gaps from that intro and give us a little glimpse of your personal life.
44 years old. I began memory training when I was 18. I took a memory seminar. I really liked it. And so I've been teaching people how to improve their memory for 26 years. In the middle of that 26 years, I joined the military as a reservist. I served for 8 years. And I won a couple national memory championships, set the record for the fastest to memorize a deck of cards in the United States. And I can't believe I just summed up 26 years in 10 seconds, but that's my life.
That's my life, and I'm proud of it. Well, Ron, thank you for your service being an Army combat veteran. I always appreciate fellow service members, so I really appreciate that. And what would you say today your area of expertise is? Is it memory?
Oh, without a doubt. Yes, absolutely. That's my focus and my thrust. Maximizing my memory. You know, I have an interest in memory. I'm always wanting to remember names and faces. You know, I give speeches and I do them without notes, but also teaching others. I would say that beyond a shadow of a doubt, my expertise is memory.
Literally 99% of people say this. I'm definitely guilty of it as well. Oh my God, I'm so bad at remembering names, blah, blah, blah. Like, again, I've said it 100 times too. What can we do, Ron, to improve at remembering people's names?
Well, you know, the first thing is when you don't remember somebody's name, think about this. How many times has this happened to you? You're introduced to somebody, and 2 seconds later, you're looking at them, and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I have no idea what this person's name
all
is.
All the time.
Yeah, and it's not because you have a bad memory. In other words, you're not forgetting the name in 2 seconds. You were never listening. You were never paying attention. I mean, the most honest thing you could say at that moment is, hey, you know, a few seconds ago when we were being introduced, I wasn't even listening to you, right?
I was zoned out. So what do we do?
So, here's a good question. You can ask yourself, start doing this one thing. If you start doing this, you'll triple your retention for names. As you're walking towards somebody from now on, it's a new person. You're at a business meeting. You're at a friend's house. You're at a restaurant. Somebody's walking towards you. You never met them before. Instead of asking yourself, have I seen this person before? Have they bought my product? Do I have that stain on my shirt from – does my hair look okay? Instead of all that, ask yourself this one question. What is their name? What is their name? What is their name? What is their name? Now, don't say that out loud, all right? But here's the problem. You know, Brian Tracy says nothing focuses the brain more than well-worded questions. Better. Nothing focuses it better than well-worded questions. So if we can begin to ask ourselves questions and develop that habit, that it's going to focus our brain at that moment, at that instant. And, you know, the next thing you can do is look at their face, observe a unique feature. Maybe they have big nose or big ears or bushy eyebrows or a thick beard, and really focus in on that distinctive feature until you take notice of it. And then they extend their hand. They say their name is Steve, and this guy has big ears. Instantly, I will think Steve, stove. And I begin cooking those ears in a stove. Or if his name is Matt and he has big ears, I will see a doormat on his ears. But I'm visualizing pictures on the face. And I'm really seeing it. And as I walk away, I imagine that story in my head. Man, that guy was wiping my feet on his ears. Or man, that guy was cooking his ears. And it sounds silly and it sounds crazy, and it is, but it does work.
I believe it. I don't think I'll ever forget Matt's name, ever. I can picture him right now. So, Ron, let's do a little bit of a shift now. And by the way, thank you for that. That's huge. I am definitely going to try that. I want to talk about your worst entrepreneurial moment to date. So take us back there. I'm sure you can remember it. So take us back to that moment. Tell us that story.
Well, you know, I've been an entrepreneur for 26 years. And when I was 25 years old, I made $20,000 that month, and it was the most I'd ever made in a month. And I thought I was, you know, Rockefeller or something. I had made, whoa, I was a big shot. So I was running my mouth, telling everybody about, you know, how much of a rich and successful business person I was. And of course, I'm being sarcastic here. And, you know, I was at the local pool hall playing pool, and there was a guy there, and he listened to me talk for about a week or so. And then he began to talk. And when he began to talk, he seemed to have all the answers to my business problems that I didn't know I had. And he within a couple weeks, he became my business partner. He convinced me I needed him. And within 2 months of that, I had no money in my bank account. I called one of our mutual friends on the phone, and I said, man, I think Thomas just stole from me. And he said he did. He is a professional con artist. He conned an insurance company out of $1 million. He conned he made the front page of a newspaper in Connecticut called the Hartford Advocate. He made the front page of that, and it was called The Art of the Con. And I thought, well, I could have used this information about 2 months ago, you know, but he was. Next thing you know, I'm totally broke. I literally got kicked out of my apartment that day. Had no money, nothing in the bank account, and I took a job as a waiter, and I was living in my car. And I remember, you know, waiting tables. I'm a speaker. I speak at conferences. I was, you know, I remember waiting tables one day, and this was maybe a month afterwards, and a guy comes in, and he's a guy I had spoken for his conference. You know, 3 months prior, I'd been in a suit and tie up on the stage, and he had hired me to speak. And now I'm waiting on him at the Red Robin restaurant asking him if he wants more fries. And it was just such a low, you know. But I found it shocking in a way. I was living in my car, eating bananas. You know, you hear every motivational speaker say living in a van down by the river.
Right.
So I hate telling this story because it sounds like so cliche, and I don't want to be cliche. But it's true. I did. But it, you know what? It wasn't even that bad. It wasn't even that bad. I would say that was on the surface, my worst entrepreneurial moment. And I don't even blame the con artist. I don't blame him, because I'm the idiot who, when he said, hey, sign this document, I signed it without reading it. And what it really was giving him permission to access my funds in my bank account. I didn't read it. I'm the idiot, not him. So I don't blame anybody. But that was a low point. I'd say that was a low point for me.
Yeah. You know, I kind of like how you said it wasn't even that bad, you know, with all the things that you ended up going through and having to do X, Y, and Z. And Ron, what would you want our listeners to really make sure, or what do you want our listeners to really get from that story? Kind of just sum it up in one or two sentences.
That whatever your worst fears are, if it happens, it's probably not that bad. Barring the death of a loved one or yourself or a friend,
yeah.
Barring death, it's probably not that bad. So don't worry about it. Don't stress. And that would, in other words, we play it too safe, I think, a lot of the times because of our worst fears.
Ron, do you read Stoicism, or do you consider yourself a Stoic?
You know, I don't, but I'm very fascinated by
it
all of a sudden.
Get on the topic, brother. There's some great books. You know, I definitely would just Google. Tim Ferriss has written some great articles on it. Stoicism. I mean, Marcus Aurelius back in Rome. Really, really cool people over the years. Now, let's talk about one of the greatest ideas you've had to date. I mean, you just told the story of how you got conned, but you know, the reality is you've been an entrepreneur for over 26 years. You've had a lot of aha moments. Take us to one of those, Ron. Tell us that story.
Well, my greatest aha moment, you know, I'm in the speaking training business. You know, for the first 7 or 8 years, I was out speaking and training and doing seminars, and I called up a guy. He's passed away now. His name's Billy Burden. he was a guy who was a predecessor in the memory field that I'm in. He said, "Ron, you really need an audio course." Cassettes is what he said. You know, this was in the 90s. "You really need cassettes. People want to take something home with them." And, you know, for me, the greatest thing I did was duplicating myself through audio. And I remember Brian Tracy was speaking at a same conference I was probably 20 years ago. And I said, "Brian, I'm going to write a book." He said, "Why are you going to write a book?" I said, "So I can sell it and make some money." He said, "You could sell a book for $15. You can sell an audio course for $20. And he said, "You shouldn't write a book." And for me, that biggest aha moment was just duplicating myself through some form of audio or video. That has been the greatest boom to my business. And especially with the internet, everything took off. But I'm so grateful I did that 20 something years ago.
Love that. And just what's the one thing you want to make sure that we get from your aha moment?
Duplicate yourself somehow. Figure out some way to duplicate yourself. It may not be through audios or videos, but there's got to be some way you can duplicate yourself.
Fire Nation, all we have is time. You have to figure out ways to scale, way to leverage your knowledge, your abilities, your voice, your work, whatever that might be. Now, Ron, today, 2017, what has you most fired up?
You know, I am Tim Ferriss just did a podcast on this. I love cryptocurrency.
You know? Yes, it's fascinating.
I mean, it is. And I am really excited about that. I am really fascinated about that, about the blockchain and about technology. But you know, it's and that really does have me really excited. But I would say that, you know, just in general, I love learning about new things. And right now, one thing I'm really trying to dive more into is languages, and really just I feel like it opens up a whole world to you when you can get languages. The next one I want to really tackle is Thai.
That's not an easy language from what I hear, Ron.
I heard somebody told me it wasn't so bad. So hopefully they're right. But, you know, I think when you can speak more languages, obviously it just opens up, you know, a different world to you.
Yeah. Well, hey, we've been talking about Tim Ferriss a little bit today, so we might as well keep the trend up. But he has some great articles and actually podcasts about speed language learning, which I think is really cool. So definitely check those out as well. And if you think, Fire Nation, that Ron's been dropping value bombs, well, you're right, he has. But check it out. The lightning round's coming up, and he's going to drop value bombs galore after we thank our sponsors. Let's get personal, Fire Nation. Are you suffering from LBNI? Don't be afraid. It's actually quite common. It stands for learning but never implementing. If you just answered yes, then great news. My friend Billy Jean has the perfect cure. Grab a pen or turn on some major memory power. On August 31st, 2017, Billy Jean is hosting a private workshop for marketers and entrepreneurs at the Hard Rock Hotel in downtown San Diego. He's laying it all on the table and has one goal in mind: to have every attendee leave with a Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube ad ready to launch. What? So if you're tired of learning but never implementing, now's the time to turn it around. Visit buildadswithbilly.com and reserve your spot today. This workshop's almost sold out, so be sure to check it out at buildadswithbilly.com. My definition of a lifestyle business is one where you decide the hours you work and who you want to do work with. But it can be a struggle getting started with so much information out there. What if I told you there's an opportunity to enter the world of business consulting with a complete system ready for you to run with? If you're a business consultant, coach, or advisor, or interested in becoming one, then you should check out ConsultX. ConsultX is an online cloud-based application that has all the training you need to become a successful business consultant, taught by experts who have been in the profession for over a decade. Start your free 14-day trial today by visiting consultx.com/fire and clicking the free trial tab at the top of the website. No credit card required. That's consultx.com/fire. Ron, are you ready to rock the lightning rounds?
I am ready to rock the lightning rounds.
What was holding you back from becoming an entrepreneur?
Doubt. I was 18 years old and I looked 12, and I was just doubt that I was old enough to do it. that carries over in different forms today. It's no longer age, but doubt.
What's the best advice you've ever received?
It was a quote somebody told me, and they said, a year from now, you'll wish you had started today.
It's a personal habit, Ron, that contributes to your success.
You know, I am really, this is going to sound cold-hearted, but I'm really able to compartmentalize negative feedback and criticism. I just ask myself, if I died today, would that person be at my funeral in 3 days? And most often the answer is not. So most often is, I don't care. And it really helps me not to get worked up over criticism or you know, criticism, I guess you'd say. I really don't get worked up over it. And that helps me out a lot.
Can you share an internet resource that you're digging right now?
There's a .org out there called memorize.org, memorize with an S, and it's memory games. And I'm a memory guy. There is another one out there, and this one is not owned by me. I'm not affiliated in any way. Matter of fact, it's owned by one of my competitors. But Memrise, M-E-M-R-I-S-E, memrise.com. Awesome resource. It's so awesome. I'm jealous that it's not mine. But it is an awesome resource if you want to learn languages. I mean, you can literally go on there and take free courses on Spanish. It's a free website. It's awesome.
If you could recommend one book, what would it be and why?
There's a book out there called Mind Gym. The author of it's a guy named Gary Mack. It's a book about peak performance and how your mindset what you think will affect you physically. When I was training for the USA Memory Championship, I got this book and it made such a huge difference in my mindset competing for this memory championship. But it's really a book about professional baseball players. This guy had access to Ken Griffey endorsed this book, Ben Crenshaw, the golfer. I mean, he's a sports psychologist, and it is so fascinating about the nuances of our thoughts and how it will affect the physical things that our body does. It's just anybody who competes at anything, even in business, I would recommend Mind Gym by Gary Mack. The book influenced me so much, I reached out to the author. I found his email address and I emailed him. This is about 5 years ago. And I got a reply back from his widow. She said he'd passed away. But what a great book. Mind Gym.
Ron, let's end today on fire with you giving us a parting piece of guidance, the best way that we can connect with you, and then we'll say goodbye.
Well, my parting piece of guidance is your brain and your memory is so much better than you think it is. I set the record by memorizing a deck of cards in 90 seconds. It was the fastest ever in the United States. Anybody can improve their memory to remember whatever they want. I have a free gift for your listeners at memorytips.net, memorytips.net, not .com. And my parting thought would just be, your brain is much more powerful than you think it is. However, whatever level you think your memory is right now, double it, triple it, 10x it. You're not going to approach it. I recently memorized 7,000 words in sequence. The limit, whatever you think the limit is, 10x it. And you're probably still not even there.
Sheesh. Love all of that. Fire Nation, you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with. You've been hanging out with R Dubs and JLD today. So keep up the heat. And head over to EOFire.com. Just type Ron in the search bar. His show notes page will pop up with everything that we've been talking about today. These are the best show notes in the biz. Timestamps, links galore. And memorytips.net is a place to go to learn more. And any parting words for Fire Nation, Ron?
Hey, you guys are awesome. No matter what it is you're fearing doing right now, do it. And if you fail, it's not going to be half as bad as you think.
Hey, Fire Nation, hope you enjoyed our chat with Ron today. And we have a free 8-day goals course for you. It's just waiting at freegoalscourse.co. Get goal focused. I will catch you there, or I'll catch you on the flip side. If you're a business consultant, coach, or advisor, or interested in becoming one, then you should check out ConsultX. Start your free 14-day trial today by visiting consultx.com/fire and clicking the free trial tab at the top of the website, consultx.com/fire. If you suffer from learning but never implementing, then great news. My friend Billy Jean has the cure, because on August 31st, 2017, he's hosting a private workshop for marketers and entrepreneurs, and he's got one goal in mind: to have every attendee leave with a Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube ad ready to launch. Visit buildadswithbilly.com and reserve your spot today.